Ghosty is a new terminal emulator that's been getting a lot of attention this year. For good reason. It was created by a beloved developer using languages Zig and Swift, which are super hot this year. It's cross-platform, so you can use it in Linux or macOS. It's configurable through plain text files, and it has just the cutest little logo I've ever seen in my entire life. Now, if you want a great video on the state of terminal emulators on Mac, Theo made a great video here. This video is a little more practical. I assume that you, like me, have been a little bit busy, and it's kind of hard to dive into a new tool that is so critically used every day. So today, you can follow along with me as I set it up with my five criteria for a terminal emulator. First is plain text config. What does it look like to configure? Second is related to that, how easy is it for me to load up an alternative configuration file for screencasting. Third, how easy is it to load themes? Fourth, how well does it play with TMUX? And finally, the X factor, how much do I like it? Are there features that I didn't even know I was missing using my current emulator, Alacrity? Let's get into it. Okay, so back over to the cutest webpage I've ever seen. Let's go to download and see what kind of instructions we have. For macOS, we can do universal binaries or use a package manager. For the moment, I'm using Homebrew to manage all my packages, but I'm very interested in NixOS. So we can easily copy this, but I'm gonna do it a little bit differently based on my config. I manage everything through a brew file. I save these with my .dot files, which makes it super easy to set up new machines. We have both terminal programs as well as these cask GUI programs. Now, Ghosty is a GUI, so we're gonna find this G section and just add a cask for Ghosty. We'll write and quit and just run brew bundle. Super easy as that. See that we're installing Ghosty now, and we should be able to run it. And there we are, easy as that. So super painless setup. Now let's jump into the configuration. Imagine we'll find that in docs. The first thing I'd like to configure is the size. So right now it's pretty small for this video. And they mentioned that while they strive to be zero config, there are some things that are highly subjective, like the theme, as well as font size, etc. Now, these days, I prefer to use the config directory in .config, ghosty config. I know there's a specific Mac directory, but let's start here and see what we get. Looks like we don't have anything, so let's make a directory for in .config and touch the file config. Now, it doesn't look like there's any type of file format on the end of that, I assume by design. Let's open this and see what we get. So first things first, when I open neovim, this theme looks correct, which is a good start. Let's grab these keys and see what they do. Background and foreground color, and see if these are auto-loading. Let's change these around and see what we get. What if we open up a new window? No. So how do we reload this config? The configuration can be reloaded at runtime by pressing Control Shift comma on Linux or Command Shift comma on a Mac. Command Shift comma. Oh, hey, crazy. All right, there we go. But if we go back into Vim, we should still see. Okay, so it is colliding a little bit with our neovim config. No problem. Okay, now what I really wanted was font size. So where are our options? Looks like we can run this command, show config, to see what is currently set. Give ourselves a little bit more breathing room here. And there's just tons and tons of stuff. So we may need to run that through less. Let's try looking for font size. Can we find size somewhere? After some digging, I finally found font size equals the number. Let's change that to 24. Command shift comma. So I'm not seeing updates. So I asked Perplexity and it seems like we need to restart or reopen Ghosty. Let's change this to something notably larger and quit this and reopen Ghosty. Let's actually quit it this time. Okay, so this worked. I'm not sure why, but for whatever reason, if you're gonna change the font size, we have to fully restart Ghosty. So let's get this back in. Not totally flawless there, but I'm sure that there's some reason for that. Okay, so we have a basic configuration file. We know how to auto reload it. We know that font size is a little bit weird and we have to fully restart Ghosty. And we also know the command that we need to run to see all the configuration documentation. Check, check, check. My next question is if I can set up a alternative configuration that I can easily load when I want to do something like screencasting. So Ghosty does allow for splitting config into multiple files, and their solution is pretty cool. It has this config file key, which you can use to link to various paths. And this is helpful specifically if you want to have platform specific or machine specific configuration. Prefixing that with that question mark means that it won't fail to load. It'll just be ignored if it doesn't exist. Now, that doesn't really help me in wanting to load alternative configurations, but I wonder if I can use this key as an argument, the same way that we're using the font family argument up here. So first of all, let's just run this and see if it works for us. Ghosty, font family, JetBrains mono. So this doesn't seem to work, and I'm not entirely sure what this error message means, but I'm going to try quitting Ghosty and running this from a terminal to see if we can open it from another terminal. And it looks like the answer is no. So that's a little bit weird, but it looks like ultimately we wouldn't, if we can't even use this one, we won't be able to use the more advanced config file. So we'll have to look into that. So custom configuration, a little bit of a bust. Not a huge deal. I can just kind of have a couple commented fields, but that is something that I would like to see in future versions of this. Let's jump to TMUX. How does it do with TMUX? So one cool thing that I've noticed about Ghosty is that we can open up our config by typing command comma, and it opens it inside of TextEdit, which is really nice when we want to test some things out, make changes to our Ghosty config without having to jump around inside of files here. So we're gonna start by commenting these out, command shift comma to reload. And I wanna open up TMUX. These are prefix with C to create a new window, ls a couple things, can use prefix S to see any of our open sessions and jump to those. Our neovim theme is working correctly, which overall is pretty nice. However, we'll notice that the green here is actually a different green from the Tokyo Night theme that I'm using inside of neovim. And using prefix N to jump to the next window, we get the default theme from Ghosty. Now, I'd like for these to match, but it is nice that they seem to be isolated enough that they work well with each other. Okay, so the last thing I want to check is using prefix left bracket to navigate the text on this page using vim motions. Begin a selection, select, prefix N to go back to my editor, P to paste. Cool. That all works. Okay, so those are my primary use cases with TMUX. I don't use it a ton or do anything fancy with, you know, networking and whatnot. But I do want to figure out that theme situation so this can start to feel a little bit more like home. So back in the Ghosty docs, we're going to go down to color theme and see what we have here. So there are a number of built-in themes, it looks like, and we can even list the themes. So let's try that command out. Fix D to detach from our TMUX session. And run the Ghosty themes command. Whoa, this is sick. So this whole theme explorer, it looks like. I'm using Vim's J and K to navigate this list, but arrow keys work as well. Can I search with forward slash? Yes, I can. So forward slash will search. I've been using Tokyo Night. So if I hit enter, let's see what happens. Okay, so this is just a listing. So we'll queue to quit and open up our Ghosty config file. Here we'll use the theme key and do Tokyo Night. Now, it's interesting because it looks like we can set up light and dark themes respectively using this very Tailwind-inspired dark and light theme separated by a comma, which is actually super cool. So let's save this at first. Command shift comma to reload. Now, if I quit this, yes, we have our fully Tokyo Nightified theme. Okay, to test light and dark theme, let's jump over to appearance in system preferences and change to light. I'll change our whole system, but it won't change our Ghosty because our configuration is set up to only have a dark theme. But we can place dark here and use a comma for light. And I think there was a Tokyo Night light, but if I do command shift comma to reload, we get an error. This will do dash day, command shift comma to reload. We see that Ghosty changes, but neovim doesn't have the same configuration, so we won't see it here. But Ghosty is loading that for our light appearance. And it should theoretically change back automatically when we change our system appearance. That's super nice. Okay, so let's talk about an X Factor thing that I was really happy to see. A keyboard shortcut that I've become really accustomed to on a Mac is option backspace to delete back to white space or certain characters. And this actually has to be set up in certain terminals. So if I do 1, 2, 3, hit option backspace, it only goes back one character. The option doesn't modify it. So I would have to set up use option as meta key. And once I create a new window, 1, 2, 3, this works. But there are some pretty serious disadvantages to this. It kind of screws up some of the other commands inside of a terminal emulator. However, in Ghosty, without any additional configuration, this option works. All right, so that's my exploration for today. Hopefully this was helpful for you, me just kind of setting it up for the first time. So far, I really like it. It seems really easy to configure and it is closer to my personal defaults, which is really nice. It's just less config that I have to have laying around. I'm a little disappointed that I don't have an option for loading different config on demand that seems to work. If you know how to fix that for me, let me know. I would love to learn from you on that. So that's it. You're awesome. Get out of here. Build your own custom config with Ghosty. Share with me the things that you learn. I'm super excited to learn from you. I'm Chantastic. See you next one. Bye.